No.
Now, this will not work on anybody in the audience. So later on, if somebody beside you says, hey, I think it's starting to work on me. If that happens, just flick them in the face. This thing. All right, everybody. Thank you for volunteering. I'm about to put you into a trance. When I do this, you're not going to feel any different. In fact, when I do, you might say to yourself, I don't think it's working, but it will be, and I'll prove to you a couple moments later. All you need to do is focus on these shut the distractions and stuff will work. Who is sitting or standing beside somebody they know really well? If you are, you cannot be, because you'll spend all your time doing this.
Is working on you.
So shuffle yourselves around. You're beside somebody you know, you do not want. Alright, cool. Your positions are very important. If you're sitting in a chair, you're sitting up straight in the chair. Your feet are flat on the floor in front of you. Your hands are resting in your lap. Your own lap.
No.
And if you're standing, your hands are down at your sides. What I didn't tell you earlier, I'm only going to be doing the base of this show with about half of you. Yeah, I'm going to start off with some preliminary tests. Those were the most focused. Those were shutting up distractions are the ones I'll be keeping on. Okay, do your best to stay up and focus on me, and it's definitely going to work. Let's begin. I need everybody's undivided attention right here in my hand. Nothing magical about my hand, just a visual line or a place where you stare. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, feeling. Let's do that together again. Inhale. And exhale, as you focus right here in the center of my hand, realize a lot of what I'm about to say won't necessarily make sense to your conscious mind. But your unconscious mind, it'll make perfect sense. I'll be speaking what's known as a hypnotic language pattern. Your brain will take segments of what I said and all its own in a way that's completely unique to you, assembled into a trance so wherever we go, whatever we do, that's all right. The longer you're here, the stronger, the faster things work, better moves you in. No stress, no pressure at all. Like everybody, voluntarily close your eyes now and listen to this. As you focus, only in the sound of my voice, that's all that's really important. Shut out all the distractions around you. You can allow yourself that uncanny ability to focus only on me, because as you do, realize, in a moment, your imagination is going to be unbelievably clear, unbelievably vivid. The things I describe seem in amazing detail. Simply because you, through your own unconscious mind, allow yourself to focus even further. And as you do, realize when I start things, it works fast, it works strong. Until you hear me say the word erase. Anytime you hear me say the word erase, whatever was happening, well, stop immediately. Until I started it. When I started it, it was even faster than I did this step before. Allowing yourself to focus even further. I snap at us on the count of three, you won't feel any different, but it's already starting to work. I'm about to prove that to you. You can open your eyes on the count of three. One. Two, open your eyes on three.
Jessica, three.
Welcome back. We're doing something all right over here. I'm wide awake now. Hello, welcome back. All right. Yeah. We'll begin with okay. Going on to test number one. Everybody, both hands straight up like this. The right hand goes palm down. Keep your hands apart. And if you're standing in the third row back, make sure you're not touching anybody with your hand. And focus right here. Deep breath in. Exhale, feeling fine. Close your eyes now. And listen to this. Although you're completely wide awake and totally aware, I want you to imagine that you can still see me. And I want you to imagine that I'm holding in my left hand a dictionary. It's a heavy dictionary. In fact, it's quite thick. It's a reference style dictionary. It's a type of dictionary you can find in the library. I want you to really focus on what this dictionary looks like. Give it a color. No matter what color you want it to be, you can't possibly be wrong. If there's any writing in this dictionary, make that clear as well. Make it so clear, make it so vivid, it sits there in your own mind's eye. Realize that in a moment, I'm going to drop this dictionary in your left hand. You'll feel the weight of it there immediately. You're not going to feel it already. But first, allow this dictionary to float in closer so you can actually see the texture of the cover of all this clarity. I'm going to give this dictionary to everybody all at the same time. It won't start. You'll keep your eyes shut. That's on the count of three. You already focus on it. One, two.
and three. Feel the nature in the left hand. You're going to discover that this dictionary can slowly start to get heavier. Now, as the weight begins to increase, you can allow yourself to focus. If you're standing, remain standing. Don't lose your balance, but focus on this. I want everyone to shift your attention for a moment over to your right wrist. I'm going to tie an imaginary string over to your right wrist. Attached to this string is a clear helium balloon, which is absolutely weightless. You're going to feel the opposite effect going to take place on the right hand on the count of three, as it will start to slowly and effortlessly rise into the air all on its own. That's on the count of three. You're already focused on it. One, two, and three. Absolutely weightless. That's right. As it floats effortlessly into the air, as you allow yourself to focus. Listen to this. Don't float away on me now. Listening to this. She's okay. Listening to this. I can never be another dictionary in the left hand twice as heavy as last. Are you ready? One, two, three. Feeling it now. That's right. And another clear helium balloon. I'm going to snap the all over this on the count of three. Once you open your eyes, look at your own hands. One, two, wide awake on three. Now. Good morning. Give them a big round of applause. So far. I will be sending some more of it back in a little while. Test number two.
This is really cool.
Everybody, both hands straight on front of you like this. Interlock your fingers. Close up all the gaps in between your fingers. Lock the elbows. Press the palms. I'm going to explain to you what's about to happen. In a moment, I'm going to count to three. Once I get to the count of three, the harder you try and pull your hands apart, the tighter the key will lock. I know that sounds weird, it sounds impossible, but because your subconscious mind is already taking over the process, the trance is already beginning, your hands will simply refuse to open once I get to the count of three. Let's set it all up right here. Make sure your elbows are locked down tight. Eyes open. Focus right there. Deep breath in. Exhale, feeling fine. As you focus right there in the center of my hand, realize, once I get to the count of three, the harder you try and pull your hands apart, the tighter they continue to lock. That's because the trance has already been set up slowly for beginning to unleash. We're going to do this externally with your eyes open, which causes the trance to move faster than it was just a moment ago. I don't want you to focus on my hand anymore. I want you to focus on your own. Get a good look at your own hands. I want everybody to start to apply some pressure on your hands now. Squeeze your hands together. Do it on your own at first. The more you stare, realize the tighter they continue to lock. They go a little bit tighter than you thought you'd actually squeeze them yourself. That's because of the trance. The more you stare, the tighter. The tighter the pressure continues to build, going unbelievably tight. Seizing further, once I get to the count of three, they simply refuse to open. When I say erase, they open easily, but the pressure builds further down. Stare at the hands. Realize there's a link between your eyes and your hands. The more you stare, the tighter. The tighter the pressure continues to build, going unbelievably tight. Staring further, I'm going to start the count on one. As the pressure builds further, lock it tighter. Two. Superhuman strength, unbelievably tight, totally seized, refusing to open, completely locked. On three, go ahead and try. The harder you try, the tighter they lock. Do anything, they simply refuse to open. Will you erase it all on the count of three? One, two, three, erase. They open now. Is anybody still locked? Some people just pop on the ground. We'll rescue if necessary. On the end there, some people in the park. We got one there still locked. I'll see you in a second. Focus in. Erase now. They open easily. Let it happen. Does anybody know that works? All right, give them a big round of applause. We're finished with the stupid stuff. Now we're going on to the really stupid stuff. Focus right here. Deep breath in. Exhale, feeling fine. If you're standing, your hands are down at your sides, never in your pockets or behind your back. Deep breath in again. Exhale, feeling fine. Close your eyes now. And listen to this. You're about to be hypnotized very quickly, simply because you are a dog.
So the transit very slowly, very subtly, now, we're going to unleash it.
We're going to allow it through the different parts of our unconscious mind as you focus further on the time. I'd like everybody, slowly, start to get tired. Start to get extremely relaxed, extremely tired, so every drop of stress immediately begins to fade away. Do not get ahead of me. Focus only on the sound of my voice. That's all that's important. I would like everybody to begin to pay particular attention to the muscles in the back of your neck. In a moment, those muscles will be so much more relaxed than they were just a moment ago. Wouldn't it be worth holding your head up in the position that it's in? Or was it? Your head will never snap backward heavily. It will always go forward. Chin towards your chest. That's on the count of three. You're ready. Focus on it. One, two, and three. Allow your neck to relax. That's right. As it does. Begin to discover that this relaxing sensation starts in the back of your neck. Notice now how it can slowly begin to spread down your shoulders. And as it starts to spread down your shoulders, go into it even further. Be so much more relaxed than you were just a moment ago. Realize in the moment, you may choose to become far more relaxed than you are right now. In a moment, you may choose to rest across the floor or across the chairs. When you do, you'll always go slowly and comfortably with full control on your mind. So if you're standing, begin to discover the muscles in your ankles can start to get a little bit weaker. Now, as your ankle starts a little bit weaker, you can also discover how the backs of your knees can slowly begin to unlock, and you can slowly, carefully change your position as much as necessary. That's right, go and do it even further. Focus only on knees. Continue to rest and dream, feeling comfortable. Listening to this, I will be sending some of you back into the audience in just a moment. If I touch you on the head and sending you back into the audience, give her a round of applause as she goes. Everybody else, go deeper now. If you're managing to stand, allow the back of your knees to unlock. Now, that's right. Feeling fantastic.
Oh my God.
If you're sitting in a chair, imagine a far more comfortable position. And go and do it further. That's right. Change your position. Imagine a more comfortable position. And go even deeper. That's right. Don't stress at all. Listening to this.
Oh my gosh. It's just like...
Feeling fantastic now and listening to this. No stress, no pressure.
Put it on the floor.
We want to prove to the audience that being in a scenario is a trance, which is the state that you're in right now. We want the audience to realize that trance isn't really sleep, although it looks like sleep, it's not. You can hear the sound of my voice, you can hear the sounds of the audience. Simply don't care. So at the count of three, just to prove to the audience that you're still alive, we're going to give a little wave into the audience just to let them know that you're still there. On the count of three, a little wave. Are you ready? One, two, and three. Let them know you're there. You simply don't care. That's right. Deeper again.
That guy did.
Like death back here. If I touch you on the head, I'm going to awaken you just for a moment. Wide awake. Now, hey, how are you doing? Stand up for me. What's your first name?
Ian.
Well, over here. You follow me. Watch the bodies. again. Relax
everything. Oh my gosh.
Slowly and comfortably. Slowly and comfortably. That's right. That's there you go. Right back where you are. It's important to be comfortable. Important to be relaxed. Everybody listen to this. Some strange things are about to take place. Later on. Anytime you hear me say the word ouch, anytime you hear me say the word ouch, you're going to feel the hardest pinch in your rear end that you've ever felt in your entire life. But here's the weird thing about it. You're going to think the person beside you did it. You'll never hit one another, you'll never touch one another. You'll wonder why the person beside you touched you on the rear end. It's a right to touch you on the rear end.
You know, Jessica, she'll smack somebody.
I'm going to awaken you all just a moment, temporarily, having no idea how much time has gone by. What you're doing in the position you're in now. Well, I'd wait to the count of three. One, two, I'd wait on three. Now. Oh. Hello? Give them a big round of applause so far. Everyone, get back in your positions, please. And focus right here. Close your eyes now. Remain awake, but listen to this. I'm going to take you on a journey in your imagination. I want you all to imagine yourselves sitting here standing. A five-star luxury resort in sunny Bahamas. Everything here is perfect. Everything here is beautiful. You're on a poolside. I'm going to fill in some scenery for you here. It's your job to make things as clear as you possibly can. You need to thin the group out. You need to start to thin the group out just a little bit by touch on that. I'm going to send you back into the audience. Give her a round of applause as she goes. Give her a round of applause as she goes. Everybody else focus now and listening to this. I'm going to fill in the scenery with your eyes shut. Get a good look in front of you. There's a huge heated swimming pool there. You've been in and out of the water all day. The temperatures are perfect. There's a bar over to one end. We can pull up a chair right in the water. If somebody eats something to drink, they can clean it. Also, with your eyes shut, turn and get a good look to the left-hand side. Get a good look to the left-hand side and enjoy the scenery that's there. The beautiful rolling hills and valleys, the perfectly landscaped grass that make you appear. So beautiful. So picturesque. You put a frame around it like a piece of art. It's spectacular. And when you're out of get a look higher in the air in the brilliant blue sky with some exotic birds flying by and makes you even clearer. You can also turn and get a good look behind you because that's where the ocean is. Endless miles of beautiful white sand, beautiful blue turquoise waters, the waves come crashing down, making it clear. You can do anything here. You can go jet skiing, parasailing, deep sea fishing. Are you land on the beach and everyone will do it's all here? Oh, there's one of your friends walking along the beach. Let him go there and make it clear and listen to this. With your eyes shut, get a good look in front of you again. Let's get a good look in front of you around this pool area. If you're at all interested, get a look at the guys around this pool area. You've never seen so many hot guys in one place in one round. And you know some of them are checking you out because of how good you look. And listen to this. If you're at all interested, get a look at the girls around this pool area. bikinis and thongs are everywhere. There's even a couple of girls that have chosen not to wear their tops out here today. Look at this. Unbelievable. And listening to this, everything here is perfect. Everything here is beautiful. There's been a rumor going on around Bahamas the last couple days. You've been so busy having a good time, you've chosen to ignore what they've been saying. Is that Bahamas, at some point today, is supposed to be hit with the worst heat wave that has swept through in the last 50 years, as the temperatures immediately begin to climb up to 95 degrees. Feel the humidity in the air. And as the temperatures continue to get higher, to increase. We just rolled past triple digits now. We're past 100 degrees. A lot of people gone inside. If you're female, you'll always leave your shirt on. Remember that. But if you're a guy, cool off however you need to. You'll always leave your pants on. As the temperature get up to 110 degrees and still climbing. Your feet are the hottest part of your body. Your feet are roasting inside your socks and shoes, but they're still on. We need to cool them off so he can continue to get hotter. It's getting difficult to breathe out here, it's so hot. It's getting hard to breathe, it's so warm. Dry in the throat, dry in the lungs, getting hard to breathe. But lucky for you, you brought your shoes that double as oxygen masks. Go ahead, breathe in the air. Breathe. Oxygen in there. Perfect, finally. Back into the audience, free to go. And listening to this. Perfect temperatures. Perfect temperatures. Actually, you know what? It's starting to get a little bit cooler out here, but that's okay, seeing as how warm it was on the ground. Down to 75 degrees. Slight breeze in the air, cooling things off. 64. Seems to be cool for this time. More people are going back inside. Just you and a few others are being up here at poolside. 55. 45 degrees. Goosebumps beginning to develop on your arm. Freezing out here. You fear frostbite. You fear hypothermia. But there's one thing you do to save yourself listening to this. The person beside you is warm. The person beside you is warm. Save yourself. We're going to erase it all on the count of three. One, two, three, erase, wide awake now. Yeah, she got her socks out of her hand, I didn't even see that. Give him a huge round of applause. Get yourselves together, get your socks and shoes on. We're sending another one back. We're sending this guy back right here. Give him a big round of applause. You go. Chair available for this guy right here. As soon as you get yourself together. All right. Now there are two states you, as the audience, understand as far as hypnosis goes. State number one is the somnambulistic trance. But there's still a trance that's running the unconscious mind later on. People who don't do the weirdest things. Those who are not doing those weird things at the time, the other people watch those and they look at them and laugh because they think none of it's happened to them. Until, of course, I triggered on everybody, which is what we're about to do now. I'm going to say a word.
Oh, no.
Starts with the letter O. Ends with a UCH. There'll be no hitting, there'll be no touching, no pushing. That is impossible. The word is... away from the person that touched you. Can you send a couple more back? Can you send this girl back right here? Give her a round of applause. Good? Here's what I discovered by accident. I discovered that if I trigger the pinching at the end within a couple of minutes of doing it the first time, because they've got an anger in the unconscious mind, it's one person that feels guilty of touching them. If I trigger it again quickly enough, they'll still blame the same person. Even if they're not even sitting near them anymore. So once again, for your entertainment pleasure, there will be no hitting, touching, or pushing. That is impossible. The word is... I know, incredibly proud of your name. It's been in your family for generations. The firstborn has been named Cha-Cha as long back as anybody can remember. You're incredibly proud of your name. Anytime I should happen to mispronounce your name or forget it entirely, this really annoys you, Cha-Cha. The more I forget it, the angrier you continue to become. You keep reminding yourself, "Hey, Miss Cha-Cha," you'll get madder every time it happens. You'll never hit me with that. Your name is Cha-Cha. I'm incredibly proud of the name. It personally bothers you a little bit, but the more and more I forget it, the better and better you continue to become. I'll wake you at the count of three. One, two, one, two, three. Yeah. A guy wearing a belt, please raise your hand. Big guy that's wearing a belt. All right, what's your first name? Ian, that's right. I met her. Can I borrow your belt? Yeah, I'll get it back. Yeah, hang on with this. This next part of the show has been a personal thing. Simply because of how indirect the suggestions are that I'm about to give. So listen to different tonality changes, the way they manipulate the language. Let's see if it's felt in the way. Focus on it. And when I say focus on it, I mean really focus on it. I'm going to approach it. Very carefully, just to be sure nobody gets injured. We all know that. how sometimes we stare at something intently enough, can actually appear to become something else entirely. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to come at it from the other side while it seems to be looking the other way. I was watching a TV show and this guy grabbed him and they bit him right in the face, focus on. We have a snake lover right there. It's just a belt. Focus on it. Look, it's a belt. Why is everyone freaking out? It's a belt. Get back in your chairs, please. Look, it's a belt. We need to do something else here first. Everyone focus right here. Close your eyes now. And listening to this. Later on. Anytime you see a white handkerchief, this is the funniest thing you've ever seen in your life. It's absolutely hysterical. Every funny movie, every funny joke, every funny comedian, all wrapped up in one white handkerchief. Touching it is even funnier. The more you touch it, the funnier it continues to become. Thinking about it now is mildly amusing. Listen to this. Later on, anytime you see a green handkerchief, this is disgusting. This is so crude, this is so vulgar, you wonder how the nerve of something so disgusting on the canvas. White was hilarious, green was disgusting. Just snapped out of the sun, the count of three. One, two, wide awake on three. Now. You know, here's the cool thing about the belt at this point. Now, I can literally call it a belt. But because of the audio association, the audio anchor, that S sound I'm attached to it, I can call it a belt. Describe it as a reminder we're up here that Ian lent me the belt, but as soon as I make that S sound, they'll immediately remember what it really is. Just a belt, right? See the metal buckle on the one end. Just a belt. I get back in your positions, please. Just a belt. Ian, come here.
Hope she can drive.
You recognize that it's a belt. Put it back on.
Takes off his pants and he makes a noise again.
I love this part. Switch seats with Oh, Trump. Here's why I keep the images in the show most of the time. So I can control emotions up here. So I control emotions. If someone gets really scared, I need a snip. I can pull up the white one, or someone gets hysterical for whatever reason. I can bring up the green one. Yeah, one day I got this idea. I thought, what would happen if I got both involved at the same time? And so we're going to start this off slowly. We're going to start with one ear, because I'm going to get them both going at the same time. You won't be quite sure where to look or how to react. Yeah. Here's what I discovered about the white handkerchief. They don't even necessarily need to see it in order for it to be funny. Now watch this. Check this out. Now, what's your first thought? What's your first name? Okay. Do me a favor. You're funny. It's ridiculous, right? I'm going to poke this into my fist. Even when you can't see it, I want you to imagine that you can. Okay? And it can still be funny. Now, I'm going to give you close your hand real tight. Okay? Imagine you can still see it. Imagine that it can be funnier. The more you stare at your fist, the funnier it continues to become. I'm going to have you open your hand at the count of three to see just how funny it is. Ready? One, two, and three. Check it out. I'm sorry. That's disgusting. Completely uncalled for. My bad. Put that away. That's me. I know that's not cool at all. Jojo, what did you think of that when I did you? What?
Cha-cha.
You said Jojo before.
Nah, I said Cha-cha.
Seriously. So it's Cha-cha.
Yeah.
Do me a favor, Cha-cha. Spell that. I'm curious how you might spell it.
C-H-C-H?
No. Oh, C-H-A. You're right. Okay, yeah. C-H-A. C-H.
C. C. What?
You said C-H-A. Yeah. Okay. So is that... Yeah, it's a bit long name. So is that one word, or is there a space in the middle?
That's one word.
Okay, so Cha-Cha. Capital C-H-A. And then is the next one capital, or is this one?
It's capital.
Okay, so, cha-cha, two cha. Like the salsa, okay. So are you the one, the only, the original cha-cha? How does that go?
No, it's been through my family for like decades.
Oh, really? Wow, okay. So what's your father's name?
Cha-cha.
Okay. How about your grandfather?
Cha-cha.
What about when you have a son?
Cha-cha.
Okay, so you're cha-cha. Your first name is?
Cha-cha.
Every once in a while, two people get the same suggestion. Okay, close your eyes now and listen to this. The number six is being erased out of your memory right now. Any time I say a count from 1 to 10, you'll immediately go from 5 to 7. This makes perfect sense to you simply because the number 6 never existed as a number. Later on, if someone's trying to help, say, come on, the number you're missing is obviously 6. This won't even make any sense. In fact, you'll look at the person like they're crazy. Number 6 never exists. Remove a couple of your own. I'm going to have you for sponsor for just for a few moments. The number 6 never did exist. I'm going to wake you at the count of 3. Discovering that when you awaken, the guy beside you is wearing the most unbelievably sexy smelling aftershave you've ever smelled in your life. Why awake at the count of 3? 1, 2. Why awake on 3? Something does smell good over here. I think this dude here? Or is it you, Gigi? I can't tell.
It's
Cha-Cha.
Dude,
how do you expect me to remember your name if you change it every time?
I keep saying Cha-Cha.
You said Cha-Cha the last time?
Yeah.
Okay. You did say Cha-Cha? Okay. Your first name is... There's a microphone. Your first name is... Focus here. Close your eyes now. I'm listening to this. Only the one I'm touching right now, but further in focus later on. Anytime you hear me say the word safety, anytime you hear me say the word safety, you will instantaneously transform yourself into the world's first human seatbelt. Anytime I say the word, you'll instantly spring into action, diving across as many laps as you possibly can, trying to save the lives of those around you. That's later on when I say safety, you'll do what I said. I'll wing you at the count of three. One, two. Why don't we go three? Your first name is? You can have your name back now. You were saying your name was?
Alex.
Okay, shake my hand, Alex. Sleep, relax, every possible further, Alex, and listen to this. Alex, as you go further, later on. Anytime you hear me say the words full moon, just know what you're thinking. Anytime you hear me say the words full moon, you'll immediately jump out of your chair and you'll howl like a werewolf as loud as you possibly can. But immediately after 5 seconds of doing it, you'll snap out of it and you'll scare yourself wondering where the sound actually came from. That's later on when I say full moon, and only when I say it, I'll awaken you at the count of three. One, two, why do I count three? Say your name. Your first name is? Oh, you were Cha-Cha. I'm gonna Cha-Cha. Stand here for a second. Okay, do me a favor. Hold your left hand. Okay, we're gonna count your fingers one at a time. We'll go right to the end on this hand. Ready along with me, start with one.
One, two, three, four, five.
Right, obviously, hold it together here. Okay, we'll start with one. This will be number one. We'll go right to the end of this. Along with me, starting with one.
One, two, three, four, five.
5 fingers. Okay. We'll hold both hands up. If 5 plus 5 obviously equals
10.
Right? Okay. Put your hands up. We're going to go all the way through from 1 all the way to 10. Okay? Along with
you. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9, 10.
I got confused. Let's do that again. Okay, do that again. Okay. We see 5 here. We see 5. There's so much 10. Okay, let's count.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Is that a growth or something? I think you're thinking about that maybe something. I think I know why I'm forgetting. I don't know if anybody knows outside of it, but I happen to have a particularly bad memory. Let's get the chairs in a nice straight line and squeeze you in here. Let's have everyone sitting in a nice upright position, please. Nice upright position. The reason I like to have people in a nice upright position like this is primarily for safety purposes. Like a superhero. She really dove over. She almost got to you, Coco. That was pretty amazing. She's like, oh.
Chairs,
that means immediate disqualification. Rule number two, you must always stay away from the edge of the stage at all times. First prize is a check for $1 million. You want to win it, there's no prize. In a moment, when the music starts to climb, you will show everybody just how well you can dance. That's when the music starts on the count of three. One, two, when the music starts on three. It's not scary that I'm gone, it's just weird because you know I was here a little while ago. You won't see me.
or the microphone, you will hear the sound of my voice. You just won't be able to see me. It's not scary. I'll wake you all at the count of three. 1, 2. Why don't we go to 3? Yeah. All right, everybody. I'm just taking the wireless microphone to a different room. I want to show you all something. Stay where you are. Stay where you are. Stay where you are. I'll be right back. I'll be right back. I've just got the wireless mic in a different room. Can everybody, I'll be right back. Can everybody see the bottle of water at the front of the stage area there? Stay where you are. Focus on the ball. Focus. Something very strange is about to happen. Focus. 1, 2, and 3. How cool was that? I'm back. All right. It's all good. Here, everybody focus on the car. Everybody focus on me from the back. Focus on behind because now I'm completely naked. But the entire audience will be completely naked. 1, 2, and 3. Check this out. What is happening? Turns into a freak show. Sweatshirt's right there. Okay. Focus up here, focus up here again. Let it all begin. Close your eyes now and listen to this. When I awaken, you won't remember one thing that happened while you were up here. Allow your unconscious mind to develop and leave you on a regular basis. You won't remember one thing. All you'll remember. You came up here to volunteer to be hypnotized, and I couldn't get it to work. I've been trying for over and over again. Can't get it to work about 100 times, so when I awaken you, I'm going to give up on the whole show. I'm going to send you back into the audience, I'll send you back to groups, and we'll some of you 1 or 2 at a time. Realize every ridiculous idea and suggestion you receive while you're up here is gone. None of these is going to possibly be working later on. A key word cannot trigger a particular event. It's impossible. You've lost any kind of memory of that all back, you know, when your eyes shut. So you'll always remember what your real name is.
Well, you get a nickname for the rest of the year. You don't remember a thing that happened, only that you came up here to volunteer to be hypnotized and I couldn't get it to work. What a disaster. Trying, failing, I wouldn't give up on the whole show. I'm going to send you back into the audience, send you back in groups, some of you one or two at a time. The weird thing is this. You can take the stairs down either side, or if you choose to go over the front of the stage, you go very carefully. The weird thing is this. The second your foot touches the main level, the second your foot touches the carpet, you will instantly remember every little thing that happened while you were up here. Why we got three? Yeah. All right. You know, just have a seat, everybody. Let me explain this. It's worked perfectly in North Carolina. Yeah, just the other day. Sorry, I'm just here for you. This works everywhere else I go.
Right?
I know. Oh, really? Okay. Listen up, everybody. I need to give up on this. If it has worked by now, it's not going to. So here's what I'm going to do. Okay. I'm going to keep a few of you up here for a minute. If I gesture to you, I'm going to keep you up here for a couple minutes. So number one right there. Stay here. All right. Number two, number three, and number four. Everybody else, with my apologies, I'm going to send you back.
Give a huge round of applause!